#Digitech. So I want to start by actually presenting the issue and the problem that we actually have when we try to do agri-technologies and translate agri-technologies. How do we get accelerated innovation? And what you tend to have is when you have public, private, or academic industry partnerships, you have the academic industry on the left-hand side that's really interested in new ideas, new thoughts, new processes, new knowledges. And this is encapsulated in an idea of technology, readiness, and levels. And this comes from the European Union. So the graph up there shows that the academics like to work in levels 1, 2, and 3, where all the ideas are, and where you publish into the big journals and have the big impact factors. In contrast, when you have a connection with the private sector, with the industry, they like to obviously work at levels 8 and 9, where you have mature services, mature products that are ready to sell. And what you do have is a gap in the middle, which we tend to call the valley of death, where good ideas go to die. And this is because from an academic point of view, if I work at a university, my vice-chancellor, my dean, does not want me to work in applied sciences. And those levels 4, 5, and 6 tend to be more applied sciences. Okay, so less impact for the university, less prestige. And in contrast, if I'm a company, I don't want to move too far down that chain because then I have to put more money, more investment. So there is more risk in developing technologies. So nobody really wants to occupy this middle ground. So what we have is we have to find a missing link that allows us to jump this valley of death and get to the idea, to get to accelerated innovation. Okay, so the talk today is about how we do this, how we sort of promote the creation of these missing links, and how we do it within the concept of responsible research and innovation. So the first thing we're going to talk about is the situation in France and how the Digital Agriculture Convergence Labs and the idea of the Convergence Labs is trying to solve this problem. I'm going to give a quick comparison to the UK, which is very different there. Until recently, I was lecturing in the UK and working on the UK system. And then I'm going to come back and I'm going to give some demonstrations about how these interactions between the public and the private sector are being set up within the Digitag, #Digitag initiative. Okay. So first of all, what is #Digitag? So one of 10 convergence laboratories that are set up by the French Research Agency. These have the idea of putting research and education together, okay? So an interdisciplinary approach that's trying to address new advances that are societal and scientific challenges. So these are emerging areas. Digital agriculture is one of those. It's a fundamental change in the way that... It's a fundamental way... The objective for DigiCAD in particular is the development of digital tools in agriculture, and that's from data acquisition. It's all in Spanish. Do you want to change it to Spanish? No, it's a blog. It's okay for me. DigiCAD's objective is to develop tools, and that comes from collecting data, transforming data into information into decisions actually applied into the field, and also understanding not just the production side of things, but the social side of things. So how do growers, how do producers, how do service providers react to technology change? How do they react to issues of IP, issues of law that are associated with these new technologies? And the targets are France and Europe and several countries. So, it's 360 staff members, but these are not new members. These are, in fact, people, researchers who work in the agri-food sector that come out of existing public institutions in France. So they're